Ashley, Phil, good afternoon. I hope you guys are doing great. It's Ron. I'm out here at 144 Round Road. Looking forward to showing you guys this house. Location is incredible. As you know, it's 3.85 million. It is a 6-bedroom, 4-bath, and just under 3,000 square feet. So this is the main house here. And then as we walk here, you'll see the carriage house here. And we'll tour all of those. And then I also want to show you how close you are to the community pool. And I want to show you how close you are to the beach. Now, you'll see when we get into the interior, it definitely needs updates. There's no question about it. But for the amount of space you get and the location, this is a good value. So the question would just be if you're up for the work. Okay, so enter in the front door. It's a reverse floor plan. So we have 3 bedrooms downstairs. And then the kitchen, living, dining is on the second story. So we kind of enter into this foyer where they have bunks in the hall. Tile flooring. A little desk area over here. And then laundry here. Now the carriage house acts as a separate home. So it has a full kitchen and its own laundry as well, just so you know. Let me walk out in the back. So there is not room for a pool here. At least we don't believe that there is, but this is a very nice deck, very nice covered space. And all of this, let me span the other way as well. That door there leads to a stairway up to the carriage house. All of this space here is really just not even used. This is all part of the property for this house. And so if we did some kind of a paver patio back here, you could make this a really nice hangout space. But let's start by touring the 3 bedrooms downstairs, then we'll head up to the living area. Okay. So here we have bedroom number 1. Now this bedroom has a Jack and Jill bath, so it shares with the next bedroom we'll walk into. There's the sink you mentioned right there in the bedroom. And then we have the water closet, tub shower combo there. And this walks right into bedroom number 2. Which they have set up with a couple of twin beds. There's the closet there. If you wanted to make this just a single bed, you could put it on that wall there. You just have to put the bed frame up against the window. And then there is the sink here for that bath. Across the hall, we'll have the master bedroom. We've got a king bed in the master. Then you have a dual vanity here in the master bathroom. And you have a walk-in shower here. And this bath does have its own door right out to that back patio. One of the other 2 bedrooms had the same exterior door access. So that's floor number 1. Let's head upstairs. Top of the stairs. If you turn to the right, it opens up into your kitchen and dining room. They've got this set up to seat 10 at that large table. Nice big open kitchen. And then on the other side, we have an extremely spacious living room. That's Jordan there. You can say hi. There's your fireplace, more storage there. Now, I'm going to take you up to the 3rd floor as well, and you'll notice, I want to point it out down here before we get there, but you'll notice the bedroom or the little living space upstairs is extremely small. It only takes up about 1/4 of this space above this living room. So from what I'm told, there is lots of space to expand if you wanted to add square footage to the house. And so I'll show you that in just a second. You also have the upstairs porch here, which is also covered. So you've got another dining area here. It's a big porch and it wraps all the way around the house. You can access it from over here as well. You've got another little Juliet balcony. You have one more bedroom on this floor, and this one has a hall bath, so it shares with whoever is hanging out up here. And so you have a walk-in shower there, pedestal sink, and then the toilet there is behind the door. And this is going to be bedroom 4. Small bedroom, but definitely would work as a guest bedroom or kids' room. Okay, let's head upstairs. Oh, shoot, going the wrong way. Pass right up the stairway. So there's a door here, gets us to that stairway. Now pay attention when I look at how big that ceiling is as we go up the stairs. We're gonna look to the left when we get up to the top. So this room is only about, I don't know, 8 by 10. So fairly small room, but like I said, there is a room if you wanted to blow that back wall out and increase the space of this room. And this side is just attic space. And there's a water heater in there as well. Okay. Now let's go check out the carriage house, and then I'll show you the pool that's just 50 feet away, and we'll walk down to the beach. Jordan, we're all set in this house.
Can you notice the pool from the dining room here? Because you can actually see,
you can see it right from the dining room.
Yeah, I mean, it's literally that close.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna walk over to it, but yeah, so you can see from the dining room, oh, screen's kind of dirty, but the pool is within, like I said, 50 feet. So all of this space here is also part of the property. You could do a lot more with this. Just need some TLC. You have a 2-car garage. Hopefully they unlocked this. I'm not sure if he did.
Yep, he did.
Perfect. So there's your 2-car garage. And then we'll head upstairs. So you do have a full kitchen up here. It's a cute little island and a living room. You've got one bedroom on this level here. You've got a full bath here. And there is a laundry room in this bath as well. And there is the shower. Up the spiral staircase. And there you have bedroom 6. See, it looks over to below. All right, let's head back down. I'd like to show you where the pool and beach is located. So to go to the pool, we can actually come out this gate right here. And we'll take a, this house here is going through a remodel as we speak. So here's the outside of the house. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't show you that balcony. There is a balcony for the carriage house as well. And there's the two-car garage entrance. Okay, let me show you the pool. That's it right in front of me. So I do have a little bike rack here, but I doubt you'd need it being so close to it. And then I could continue straight down that boardwalk until I hit the next street and take a left to get over to the beach walkover. But I want to show you how you get there from the other side of the house. No, no, we're all set. I'm just going to...
The beach is just right there.
Yep, that's where I'm headed now, and then we'll be all wrapped up. So thank you very much, Jordan.
Yeah, of course. And if you need Wi-Fi, I mean, I can set you up in here. I mean, we do have Wi-Fi here, but you need to get a laptop.
I think I'm good for now. We got our office across the street, so I'll be fine. Thank you, sir.
You got it.
Okay, so you walk out the east side of the house, and you are directly on the boardwalk. You can see the water from where I'm standing. But, we'll walk down there. I guess you could fast forward this part of the video if you want to. Unless you just like hearing my footsteps. You know what? I forgot to get the code to the beach access, so... Either I'm gonna jump the fence or you're just gonna have to trust me that the beach is there. So I think this walk took me all of 1 minute to get to the beach. And some beautiful scenery along the way. All right, well, there you have it, I think. I think you're gonna have to trust me. The beach is right there. You got that little lookout platform and then steps down right to the sand. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I'm sending this to you now because we kind of have to act fast on this, and I'm gonna explain why when I call you. Talk to you soon. Bye.